What would it be like to live in a world where you pay 50% of your income to taxes? That's what we'll be talking about in today's video. Former Comptroller General of the federal government, David Walker, wrote a widely read op-ed on CNN.com back in 2009, in which he prognosticated about the future of tax rates. He said, quote, "A recent independent survey found that the average American's total federal, state, and local tax bill roughly equals his or her entire earnings from January 1st up until right before tax day. Now imagine that tax bill doubling over time," close quote. In his subsequent book, Comeback America, he further clarified his prediction. This time he described in exquisite detail exactly how high average effective tax rates would have to go in our country and by what year. Take a listen to what he had to say. Quote, "Right now, on average, Americans pay about 21% of their income in federal taxes and another 10% to state and local governments. By 2030, that amount could be at least 45%, higher even than the average 42% that most Europeans pay. By 2040, it would be at least 53% and climbing," close quote. So if average effective federal income tax rates go up to 45%, like David Walker is predicting, what exactly will our lives look like? Will it be some sort of post-apocalyptic dystopia, or do we have reason to hope? Well, as David Walker said, 45% tax rates aren't all that dissimilar from what our friends in Europe are currently paying. So we should be able to look at the lives of the average European to get a sense for the types of society we'll be living in come 2030, right? Working under that premise, let's take a look at what life is like in Denmark. The Danes pay an average effective tax rate of 42%, roughly double what we currently pay here in the United States. Take a listen to what a couple of entrepreneurs in Denmark have to say about a world in which they give 42% of their annual income to the federal government.
My name is Morten Ydfeldt. I live in Copenhagen. I'm 33 years old. And I'm a self-employed business owner, building furniture, and I've been an entrepreneur for 10 years.
And I am a co-founding partner with Morten in ChipChop. We work digitally and produce locally here in Copenhagen.
And about how much do you make?
Last month, 28,000 Danish kroner.
That comes out to about $50,000 for the year, but for their tax bracket, Morten and Chris each pay about $22,500 in taxes. How can they own homes and raise a family with just $27,000 a year in take-home income?
It helped create the society we have in terms of free healthcare, daycare for kids, free schools.
Imagine if the government paid all those things for you. What would your life be like if you didn't have to worry about medical bills or unemployment or student loans? The average student debt for an American college graduate is $28,650. But in Denmark, students pay nothing for tuition and in fact are paid $900 a month to attend college. And once they're out of school and debt-free, they'll enter a workforce where their well-being is valued. I asked Morten and Chris about work-life balance.
So it's all set in Denmark. It's 37 hours a week.
So that's, even though you're a business owner, is that?
No. That's
it's different for you.
Yeah, it's different for us.
And then people usually work more. People we know here in Copenhagen who've also taken a university degree and doing definitely that is the trend. Yeah. People, yeah, your contract will say 37 hours, but you will work way more.
Interesting.
You will work during the night, you will check your email, you will
Okay.
But I think if you go outside of Copenhagen, a lot of people work their 37 hours, they go home and they do whatever
so
they like.
So the work-life balance is much better.
Yes. I think it's a city thing.
So, okay, the idea that everyone works only 37 hours a week turns out to be something of a myth. But still, most workers here get a minimum of 5 weeks of vacation a year, compared to an average of 16 days for Americans. And Danish laws for parental leave offer 52 weeks off for new parents, while the U.S. remains the only developed nation that does not require paid leave for new mothers. But it's not all rye bread and aquavit. Look, the reality is that half your income going to the government, well, that can sting.
I feel it's, I can sometimes feel that it's a lot of money.
You do?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. You really have to consider where those money goes and what you spend them for and what the government spends them on.
Yeah, it is a lot of money, of course.
Right.
But also, as entrepreneurs, if we fail in building up our business, we will still have money to live from, provided by the state. So, yeah. It's a bit of give and take, I would say.
According to a recent Gallup poll, 9 out of 10 Danes pay their taxes with some degree of happiness.
So, not bad, right? They are giving up 42% of what they make, meaning they're working the first 5 months of the year for the government. But take a listen to what they're getting in return. 5 weeks of paid vacation, 52 weeks of paid paternal leave, free university education. In fact, they're paying you to go to school, free health care, free daycare, and a 37-hour work week. Now, I'm not here to argue politics, but you can't deny that the Danes are receiving substantial real-life benefits in exchange for that 42% effective tax rate. But here's the question. When the average effective tax rate in our country rises to 45% or beyond in 2030, what exactly will we be getting in exchange for all those taxes? And talking about the world of the post-2030 U.S. taxpayer, David Walker says that so much of that 45% income tax will be, quote, devoted to keeping the government afloat, that they'll have relatively little for everything else in life. Their homes will be smaller and drabber. There will be less to spend for cars, vacations, dinners out, and big TV sets. They will have less to offer their children, including fewer educational opportunities. They will still have some version of Social Security and Medicare, but much of their hard-earned money will have gone to pay the nation's debts, close quote. In other words, those 45% or higher effective tax rates that David Walker is predicting for post-2030 America won't be earmarked for free health care, free university tuition, 5 weeks of paid vacation, a full year of paid parental leave, free daycare, or 37-hour work weeks. Those 45% taxes are going to pay primarily for four things: Social Security, Medicare, Medicaid, and interest on a national debt that by that point will have blown past $40 trillion. So in short, what will life be like giving 45% of your income to the federal government in 2030 and beyond? In short, it won't be anything like what you observe from the Danes in this video. It will feel precisely like it sounds. You'll be forced to pay for all the things that you're currently paying for, but with substantially less income. If you currently make $10,000 a month, you give $2,100 per month to the federal government, netting you $7,900 after tax. Come 2030, that $10,000 a month will give you more like $5,500 of after-tax income at best. But you'll still be required to personally pay for all the benefits that the Danes currently get for free. In other words, not all high-tax environments are created equal. So I've painted a pretty angst-inducing apocalyptic landscape here, but is there anything you can do today to stave off this eventuality for your personal financial situation? The answer is yes, at least when it comes to your retirement savings. As a rule, the younger you are, the more likely your tax rate will climb to 50% or higher by the time you retire. And if that's the case, you have no business making contributions to tax-deferred retirement plans today. You're getting a deduction at historically low tax rates only to postpone the payment of those taxes to a period in your life when they're likely to be twice as high as they are today. And as I've demonstrated on this video, you'll be getting very little in exchange for those higher tax rates. You should instead divert your retirement savings to tax-free retirement accounts like Roth IRAs, Roth 401ks, and cash value life insurance, also known as the LIRP. Take advantage of every nook and cranny in the IRS tax code so that by the time you reach retirement, you can be in the 0% tax bracket. Why is the 0% tax bracket so powerful? Because if tax rates double, 2 times 0 is still zero. If you would like some help shielding your retirement savings from 50% taxes or higher, head on over to davemcknight.com and click on the Work with David button. I'm happy to lend a hand. And if you have any comments or questions, feel free to drop them into the comment section below. I'll respond to every single one of them personally. And don't forget to click like, subscribe, and the bell so you never miss a video. This is David McKnight. I look forward to seeing you on the next video.